Hello and welcome to Black Women's History 2023, a series where we highlight the profiles of influential Black American women. This series is presented by the National Abolition Hall of Fame and Museum, whose mission is to honor anti-slavery abolitionists, their work to end slavery, and the legacy of that struggle, and strive to complete the second and ongoing abolition, the moral conviction to end racism. Ella Baker was an influential civil rights activist who worked tirelessly for over five decades to fight for the rights of Black Americans and other marginalized groups. She was born on December 13, 1903, in Norfolk, Virginia, and grew up in North Carolina on the same land her grandparents had worked as enslaved people. Her parents were both active in their community and instilled in Baker a strong sense of justice and social responsibility. Her mother's activist spirit, as she worked with a local missionary group, particularly shaped Baker's view of her own personal desire to serve as an agent of change. In her youth, Baker attended Shaw University. Baker began her activism in 1938 as a field secretary for the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, and later as a director for some of its branches. She quickly gained a reputation as a talented organizer and strategist, and she played a key role in several high-profile campaigns, including the fight to desegregate schools in the South, and the Rand campaign to promote voting rights for Black citizens in the South as well. However, Baker became disillusioned with the NAACP's leadership structure, which she felt was overly hierarchical and did not allow for grassroots participation. In 1957, she helped found the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, where she served as the organization's first executive director. In this role, Baker worked closely with Martin Luther King Jr. and other prominent civil rights leaders to coordinate nonviolent protest and voter registration drives. Baker's philosophy of group-centered leadership emphasized the importance of empowering ordinary people to take control of their own struggles for justice rather than focusing on single individuals. For example, in 1968, she said of Martin Luther King, quote, "You see, I think that, to be very honest, the movement made Martin, rather than Martin making the movement. This is not a discredit to him. This is, to me, as it should be." She believed that true social change could only come from the bottom up, rather than from the top down, and she worked tirelessly to build networks of grassroots activists across the country. One of Baker's most significant contributions to the civil rights movement was her role in organizing the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee, also known as SNCC, in 1960. SNCC was a youth-led organization that aimed to harness the energy and passion of young people to push for social change. Under Baker's guidance, SNCC played a key role in the struggle for voting rights, organizing sit-ins, freedom rides, and other acts of civil disobedience that helped bring about the passage of the Voting Rights Act of 1965. Baker continued to be an active and outspoken advocate for social change throughout her life. She worked with a wide range of organizations, including the National Association of Colored Women, the Martin Luther King Jr. Center for Nonviolent Social Change, and the Mississippi Freedom Democratic Party. Her work helped pave the way for the feminist and Black Power movements of the 1960s and 1970s. Ella Baker's impact on the civil rights movement cannot be overstated. Her commitment to grassroots organizing and group-centered leadership has influenced generations of activists, and her tireless work helped bring about significant gains in the struggle for racial equality. Baker died on December 13, 1986, but her legacy continues to inspire and guide social justice advocates. Thank you for attending today's introduction to the life of Ella Baker. Please help us by completing a brief survey at the link available on the screen and in the video description. Your feedback will help NAACP receive funding and plan future projects like this one. Also, feel free to contact NAACP with any questions or comments via the comments section or at the contact info on your screen. Don't forget to follow us on social media, and we hope to see you at our next presentation. Thank you.